This is macOS Ken.
Another record day for Apple shares. Two bullish notes on Apple, and Apple seeds more betas. It is Thursday, the 15th of July, 2021. I'm Ken Ray, and this is news from macOS Ken, brought to you by yours truly and supported by people like you, patrons through Patreon. Find out more and add your support at patreon.com/macOS Ken. Apple set three Wall Street-type records on Wednesday. Mac Daily News hit with what, for the past week or so, has become the usual. It said shares in the Cupertino company hit new intraday and closing highs midweek. Shares got as high as $149.57 before giving back about 40 cents. They ended the day at $149.15, up $3.51, leaving Apple with a market value of $2.489 trillion. New intraday high, new closing high. What was the third record? At its highest height Wednesday, a piece from Apple Insider says Apple's market value crossed the $2.5 trillion mark. It is the first public U.S. company to cross that line, according to the report. As shares of Apple do their Rocket Man thing, a couple of analysts are singing along. Barron's checked out notes Wednesday from Citigroup analyst Gentleman Jim Suva and J.P. Morgan analyst Samik Chatterjee. We'll start with Gentleman Jim, who thinks he gets what Wall Street does not. Consensus is too low in his estimation. Demand for iPhone, the Mac, and wearables, Apple Watch and AirTags especially, is strong in his estimation. Quoting his note, "Our independent research shows that many iPhone users are purchasing Apple's newly launched AirTags and purchasing them in the four packs for $99 versus single purchases for $29. Importantly, many are also opting for key rings and loops. The result is many are spending more on the accessories than the actual AirTags without fully realizing this due to the desire for fashion and appearance over function." You know, it's not necessarily either or, but and. Anyway, Suva goes on to say, "We note accessories have even higher margins, and Apple's world-class marketing is not only upselling additional accessories, but also resulting in a network effort of users freely advertising to other users, thereby creating a virtuous cycle, which is only starting. All of this is only possible due to the Apple platform of exceptional integrated user experience and privacy." How stoked is Suva? Stoked enough to raise his profit estimates for the current quarter, the next fiscal year, and the fiscal year after that. He's got a buy rating on Apple shares and a price target of $170. J.P. Morgan's Chatterjee had a $170 target on Apple. Then he went and upped it. Barron's has Chatman saying that he's seeing both upside revisions to iPhone 12 build estimates and continued strength in Mac sales, and he thinks the street's expectations for the coming iPhone 13 cycle remain too low. Because he gets what Wall Street doesn't. Not unlike Suva, who also gets what Wall Street doesn't. Chatterjee's note says he sees a path to Apple outperforming investor expectations over a longer time horizon rather than just the upcoming earnings print. He's got an overweight rating on Apple shares. He used Wednesday's note to raise his price target on the shares from $170 to $175. Are we moving toward the future, or is it moving towards us? Whichever is happening, it's happening again in the form of OS updates. iDownload blog ran a piece Wednesday saying that Apple had released the third betas of iOS 15, iPadOS 15, tvOS 15, macOS 12 Monterey, and watchOS 8. To developers, it's likely that the corresponding public betas will be seeded in due time, according to iDownload blog. I guess that's their way of saying they aren't out now. Anyway, they weren't as of yesterday. While getting excited about features and betas feels like folly, there was something in Wednesday's Monterey beta that people were happy to see. Safari's tab bar is apparently back. Quoting a piece from Engadget, one of the changes in the macOS Monterey beta that we didn't like was the removal of the tabs bar. Senior editor Devinder Hadravar pointed out that while the new menu in its place allowed Apple to devote more screen space to website content, it made sorting through your tabs messy and tedious. With Wednesday's beta release, though, Apple's brought back the standalone tab bar, which will be enabled by default, like it was in Big Sur. I will say, I was not happy about some of the Safari changes Apple announced at WWDC. I mean, I was willing to give it a chance, but I wasn't stoked. Glad to hear the testing phase is addressing more than just the technical. If you bought a new TV last year, it may have a new feature this week. Mac Rumor says Apple's AirPlay 2 and HomeKit features have been rolling out to a number of smart TVs, and as of Wednesday, the functionality is available on 2020 Toshiba and Insignia 4K UHD Smart Fire TVs. Apple can keep using and marketing Memoji. A piece from the Mac Observer says a suit against Apple over its use of that term has been tossed. I remember this story being confusing when it hit nearly 3 years ago. In September of 2018, Apple Insider ran a piece saying the company Social Tech filed an intent to use application for the Memoji mark in April of 2016, but before registration was obtained, Apple made a play for its version of the name. The app maker alleged then that Apple formed a subsidiary called Memo Fun Apps LLC to obtain a forgotten and abandoned app using the name Memoji. Along with goodwill, Apple sought prior rights to a then-suspended Memoji trademark application from owners Big 3 Entertainment and Lucky Bunny. A deal was apparently reached as Memo Fun assigned rights to Memoji to Apple on the 4th of June 2018, the same day Memoji for iOS was introduced at WWDC. And yet Wednesday's piece from the Mac Observer says in 2018, Social Tech sued Apple, claiming that the company's Memoji feature infringed its trademark due to its app with the same name. Now, the 9th U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals says that app was only built so Social Tech could sue Apple. A ruling back in 2019 found in favor of Apple, saying the undisputed evidence in the record points to only one direction. Social Tech developed and posted its app with a singular focus on securing registration to sue Apple without any good faith regard to the commercial viability of its product. Social Tech appealed because why wouldn't they? 2 years later, the Ninth Circuit agrees with the lower court's assessment. The court on Tuesday issued a ruling agreeing with the previous ruling, saying that Social Tech did not develop its app for genuine commercial reasons. Social Tech says it will appeal to the U.S. Supreme Court, because why wouldn't they? And finally today, today at Apple Sessions, yesterday, today, and forever. Engadget says the Cupertino company is putting videos of its free workshop sessions up on YouTube. You know, you hear that and it seems kind of weird that they hadn't done it before. But they've always been live, or live-ish, even through 2020. Engadget lays out the timeline. Since 2017, all of Apple's retail stores have offered Today at Apple Sessions, free workshops where you can learn, among other things, how to get the most out of the company's devices and software. In 2020, necessitated by the pandemic, Apple started offering those tutorials online, hosting the sessions over Cisco WebEx. Starting Wednesday, the company is making Today at Apple tutorials available on YouTube. Well, tutorial singular for now. The first one will teach you how to draw yourself as a Peanuts character in Pages, according to the report. You can try it too. The 10-minute session is available now on YouTube. Seriously, if you do that, I would love to see your work. Kind of curious what you look like as a member of the Peanuts gang. Send me what you come up with. info@macOSKen.com. Coming up in a few minutes, Home On host Richard Gunter and I are going shopping. With new Apple Watches, iPhones, and Macs drawing nearer by the day, what of any of it are we planning to buy? Also, will you buy it for us, please? The show is called In a Few Minutes. Get it and listen wherever you get and listen to podcasts. macOS Ken, brought to you by me and supported by people like you, patrons through Patreon. Find out more and add your support at patreon.com/macOS Ken. Advertising handled by Backbeat Media. Online at backbeatmedia.com. You can reach me a couple of ways. info@macOSKen.com or call 716-780-4080. Until next time, that is news from macOS Ken. I'm Ken Ray.
Ciao.